I just want to dig into how new malware strains you're finding are basically including posing as ChatGPT's browser extensions or productivity tools. It feels as though malware, bad actors, are getting in on the AI hype.
Yeah, thank you so much for having me. I'm here today because we are releasing a series of threat reports on threats we've countered around the world to help keep people safe. One of the threats that I think is particularly useful for this business audience is malware. And to be thinking about. Malware are malicious tools that are designed to look innocent, but focus on compromising personal devices, compromising your accounts, and we know that they target businesses. Mm. And as you say, malware developers always try to get in on buzzwords. They're looking for ways to trick people into downloading malware. We've seen them do it with cryptocurrency. In 2022, they tried to get people to click on links suggesting that you would get access to new cryptocurrency apps. Today, they're trying to use generative AI, suggesting if you click on a link, you might get access to ChatGPT or another generative AI tool when actually you'd be downloading malware.
Fascinating. Just who within a business is the most vulnerable? Who are going to be being sent these links?
I think businesses should be conscious that malware actors target indiscriminately. They will target across the business, including maybe people who are connected to prominent leaders or individuals that might just be operating in the business and, for example, maintaining or administering the business's social media pages. The good news for all of this, though, is that there's a number of things, fairly simple things, that people can do and businesses can do to keep themselves safe, whether that's turning on two-factor authentication or using strong and unique passwords across their online accounts. And we are rolling out a series of new protections for businesses to help them strengthen their defenses on Meta and also to help them protect against malware wherever it might target them, whether that's on their devices, on their other online accounts, or on our platforms.
Nathaniel, this is a story about bad actors posting URLs that purport to take you to a ChatGPT-like product, right? That's what you've detected.
Correct.
But what I want to know is, have you detected threat actors who are actually using the technology, using generative AI to make the content they post on your platforms harder to detect?
We haven't seen significant, sophisticated campaigns relying on generative AI today. We do know that bad actors try to abuse every new piece of technology. So we expect that they're going to try to abuse generative AI, just like they've tried to abuse other innovations in recent years. That's why it's particularly important that defender teams at Meta and at other companies around the world, including in government and civil society, are thinking about how these abuses might happen and steps we can take to protect people and counter the bad actors.
Cisco warned that AI would make phishing attacks harder to detect. Do you share Cisco's concern?
We've seen some limited examples of people using AI-based tools to, for example, create profile pictures that of people who don't exist but look realistic. We've seen some cases of people trying to use generative AI tools to produce deepfake videos. So these threats are certainly out there, and it's important to be ready to counter them. That's why you need to have analyst teams that hunt for this type of thing. And the other side of generative AI is that generative AI has a lot of incredibly positive potentials. And one of them is helping defenders who are looking to protect public debate improve their detection and response systems so we can keep people safe.
Does it particularly matter where it's coming from, Nathaniel? You identified DuckTail in particular. That's a Vietnam-based cyber criminal operation. Is a lot coming from there? Can you see where a lot of this attack is stemming from?
Malware development happens all over the world, and it can be hard to tell exactly where the actors are or where they're coming from. When we are able to identify a particular company or a particular actor who's behind it, we'll take additional steps to deter them and impose cost on them. So, for example, for some of the people developing this malware, we referred them to law enforcement for further investigation, and we sent cease and desist letters. We often see or sometimes see companies that try to seem legitimate, but also operate on the dark side of all of this and try to share malware. And for companies like that, you can impose a lot of cost on them by highlighting this, by exposing what they're doing, and by bringing law enforcement and government to bear against them.
Of course, Ed, what's interesting is we're wondering about a very global cyber attack threat. We're thinking and talking to a global company that, of course, has rechanged its name, talking itself about the metaverse, but also deeply ingrained in investing in AI in some way, Ed.
Yeah. I mean, Nathaniel, I covered Meta earnings. Mark Zuckerberg really emphasizing Meta's competence in the field of AI, right? So how do you and the security team use artificial intelligence as a tool, how can it help you?
Generative AI is a novel and fast developing technology. There are a lot of places where it can have real impact: medicine, education. But I do think one of the interesting opportunities is in what we would call integrity, trust and safety, keeping people safe. You can quickly be able to identify and track and counter threats around the world. When we're moving in a global environment where there are many, many countries and there are billions of users and there are many threat actors, everything we can do to help move more quickly in countering these threats is effective. We work to pair those types of automated tools with expert human investigators who can track and counter the most sophisticated threat actors. And tying these together, pairing them up, has been most effective in countering the bad guys.